Hello, I'm Yong Peng. From then till now, welding is very important in the global industry in any manufacturing field. And most of them are using fusion welding, such as TIG, MIG, electron arc welding, and others. Today, I would like to share about crack weld repair by using friction stir welding. For my topic, the first problem statement is about weld crack. Crack is a very serious defect for any product, which also including oil and gas pipeline. A small crack always cause catastrophic fracture. If the crack is undetected, it might bring the dangerous to environment or product user. The second problem statement is about fusion weld. Although so far, most of the weld crack is repaired by fusion welding, but the fusion weld can bring a lot of defect at the same time, which is porosity, crack deformation, and more. Hence, there is two objectives for my project. The first objective is to investigate the weld repair effectiveness by using FSAM techniques. The second objective is to predict tensile strength by using linear regression through the literature review. Next, methodology. For the experiment setup, one CNC machine, one 2-pin, two pieces of AA1100 aluminum plates and one jig is needed to be used. Before start to weld, there is four different depth of crack holes will be drilled on one of the plate. For easy to recognize, I call the crack plate as plate B. For the next step, the plate B will be placed under the plate A and they will be fixed by the jig. Then the CNC machine will start to rotate the two pin and travel across the plate in one line. This can be called friction stir lap weld. Parameter for this experiment, the thickness of aluminum additive plate is 6 mm. Rotation speed is 1200 RPM and welding travel speed is 2 mm per minute. After welding process, the plate is needed to cut into 4 parts by using benzo cutting machines. Then polishing process for making the welding zone area smoother and clearly. Lastly, the scanning electron microscope is used to watch the welding zone area. Next, result in discussion. After welding, there is some defect can be observed clearly, which is flash and also groove. Groove defect is about a puff hole formed on the surface of weld joint. After researching of Jonah, this defect is normally caused by very small or very high tight angle of the 2-pin setting. In this experiment, the tight angle used is 2 degrees. Between this kind of tight angle, it might be a region caused a scanty downward forging of the plasticized material. For the next defect, which is flash. According to the journal research, this type of defect anomaly form at a higher rotation speed and a lower welding speed. Okay, now I'm going to explain about the welding zone analysis. This result is taken by scanning electron microscope. Before explaining this result, I need to be apologized for not enough time to complete due to MCO. Hence, there is only the welding zone is captured clearly. This welding zone is about 1 mm crack depth and is shown roughly filled with solid film. Furthermore, there is no porosity and no void be found in this picture. Now, I will discuss about tensile strength. The tensile strength data in the table is collected through different of journal. After collecting the data, linear regression graph is made by using Microsoft Excel. There is two linear regression graphs. As we see the rotation speed versus tensile strength, the linear line is decreasing. This shows that the higher rotation speed, the lower tensile strength. Y equal negative 0.2845x plus 372.95 is the formula which can be used to predict the tensile strength. The next linear regression graph is about welding travel speed versus tensile strength. The linear line is increasing. This shows that higher welding travel speed, the higher tensile strength. Y equal 1.3548x plus 11.394 is the formula which can be used to predict the tensile strength. Hence, as a conclusion, high welding travel speed with low rotation speed can produce a good tensile strength. Lastly, this is all for my presentation. For summarize it, friction stir welding is a very good crack weld repair because there is without porosity and void in the welding zone area. Furthermore, it is also firm to be welded together with those two plates. Besides, after collecting the data of Joner, we can conclude the high welding travel speed with low rotation speed can produce a good tensile strength. Thank you.